Imagine having to try to stay alive from predators, look for food, and then give birth to offspring, just to then get devoured by them. That's what some species of spiders have to go through. But they don't try to escape or fight them back or anything, they just simply accept their fate.
I mean, it's not like they can do anything about it.
The process of eating your own mother in nature is called metrophagy, but it is extremely rare, unlike cannibalism, where a species eats its own kind. A female spider will look for a male to mate with, and after they mate, she starts reproducing. Then, when the eggs hatch, the mother produces a nourishing fluid, which she feeds to her offspring by mouth. This process is very intense, as it requires the mother spider to produce a liquid, but using up almost all the resources inside of her. When this happens, that's when the baby spiders begin to crawl on her and begin eating her alive. Now this is very terrifying, because it's not the babies that just decide to eat her, it's the mom that offers herself as food for them. However, it's not all the time the baby spiders eat their mom. Sometimes, it's the mom that eats her kids. Although it is rare for them to act this way, they do it for, number one, the nutrients they get from the babies to survive in the wild, and for number two, when they weren't able to have a meal before giving birth, so they eat them out of hunger.
It's like giving birth for absolutely no reason.
But animals that have a cannibalistic behavior shouldn't be a surprise to us, as they are rather common, and there are over 1,500 species that eat their own kind. But then again, the kind of animal that engages in this behavior can be an unexpected one, like a squirrel.
But how can such an innocent-looking creature be such a horrendous monster?
When I found out about this, I was also surprised. Doesn't squirrel only spend their time eating acorns, nuts, fruits, and other squirrel food? Well, not exactly. Male squirrels will often kill nearby baby squirrels whom he isn't the father of. That's because female squirrels are more likely to produce a second litter in years when there's more food available, according to National Geographic. Killing the first litter will guarantee the male that he will be their father, because female squirrels have several partners before they reproduce. Jessica Haynes, who is a student at the University of Alberta, saw a male squirrel climb a tree to a female's nest, where he bit on the pup, causing it to fall through the branches and die. Haynes then discovered another dead puppy a week later, and then the entire litter would eventually vanish. Seems like male squirrels could care less about killing pups if they aren't their father.
Next time you look at these creatures, don't look at them as fluffy, cute animals that are completely harmless, because on the outside, they may seem innocent looking, but on the inside, they are complete savages.
But besides eating baby squirrels, do they eat grown squirrels? In fact, they do. Since they are omnivores, they will eat the remains of other squirrels. They'll basically eat whatever they can get their paws on. It is rather uncommon for a squirrel to engage in cannibalistic behavior, unless they were completely out of food, because the meats they generally eat are bugs and insects. But similar to spiders who sacrifice themselves for their babies, a male praying mantis sacrifices himself when mating. South African female praying mantises will mate with a male praying mantis, and then afterward, bite off the head of the male. Male springbok mantises fight the female they are mating with to escape becoming her meal, unlike other mantis species, who accept their fate. Researchers have found that males always begin conflicts, and they use this strategy to encourage mating. They were more likely to mate and escape alive if they pin them down. On the other hand, if the female pinned them down, they'd get eaten. But the male's razor-sharp claws would seriously harm females who lost the fight. According to a 2016 study, female praying mantises that eat their partners after mating lay a greater number of eggs than those who do not. The female stores the male's sperm after mating and uses it to fertilize her own eggs later. Therefore, even though it would probably be better for the guy to have several female partners and reproduce, at least when he sacrifices himself and gets eaten by his partner, his nutrients increase the chances of his DNA being passed on to the next generation. But back to spiders, it also looks like the female will eat the male after mating.
This is called sexual cannibalism.
Most female spiders will eat the males before, during, or after mating.
But times when males eat females are quite rare.
For example, male water spiders will eat females that are smaller than themselves, but mate with females that are bigger than them. Two researchers paired a group of male adult group spiders with females of different ages and sizes, and they found out that regardless of the female's age or size, the bigger males were just more aggressive and much more likely to attack them. Can't creatures just mate with each other and then go about with life, instead of eating each other, not giving the other one a chance to live? See you later,